right, so we had the pleasure of hearing this young man earlier. How many people heard him sing earlier? Okay, so most everybody, but not quite everybody. It's a short song, so I'd like for you to sing it once. But before you sing it, I'd like for you to tell everyone what it's about.
The Crucifixion, by Stephen Barber, is, well, typically it's sung from the point of view of Mary, the cross, as she has her son Jesus being crucified. However, since I'm singing it, I'm not a woman. I've chosen to interpret it differently as St. Peter instead, looking at Jesus, knowing that he has denied Jesus in, when Jesus was arrested.
That's a fascinating backstory. And I think one of the things, I'll just tell you what I wrote on your sheet, really part of the part that I remember, which is I've heard this song 100, 150, 200 times, I don't know, a lot of times. And this was perhaps one of the more convincing portrayals I've ever heard. And that kind of made me hear it in a whole new way, because it's just a little two-page song in English that a lot of people sing, and they sing the notes, and they make pretty sounds. But it was a much more captivating performance than what we're used to. And one of the things that we have, that at least I have observed about all of these fine young singers, is that we really progress. There are two aspects to our singing that progress, and sometimes they progress at different speeds. We have our technical approach to singing, the mechanics of how we go about making pretty noises. And then we have our expressive capacity, which is how we physically present the piece, how we articulate the words, how we communicate the meaning. And those sometimes come at different speeds. You're really advanced when it comes to communicating the meaning. You're very advanced at communicating the meaning at a very young age. And so what we're going to try to do with our time together is see if we can help bring some of the technical aspect up to that same level as much as we can. But these things will always progress at different speeds for all of us, for our whole lives. All right, so why don't you sing it for us once? one of the pieces of acting is we have to seem like we are feeling these things often to a much higher extent than we are actually feeling them. Because one area where you kind of, you, and it was less so this time, more so the first time, you're kind of on the boundary of maybe losing the integrity of your vocalism because of your commitment. We have to kind of walk that fine line. What are some other things that singers do to communicate meaning? There's one obvious one that the composer has given us that we've not mentioned yet.
Dynamics.
How about the words? Could we understand everything that he said? I see some kind of questioning. Well, at the outset, yes, right? But as soon as it gets fuller and more committed, we start losing your text a little bit. And so we have to be careful that we don't get so involved in what we're doing that we're then less effective at communicating to others the text of the piece or the meaning of the piece. So can we go back to, so we've got never, shall, and we also, it's never shall lament cease. The other thing sometimes we have is we've got music that the word stress we have to help make clear, right? So you've got never shall lament cease. So we get that clear. Because of that, then once we get into this next section, that's where we start losing your text. So how do we make our text clear? What are the tools that we have?
Consonants.
How about anatomical tools? Your tongue, your lips, your teeth, your jaw, right? And if those things start getting out of control, then we start hearing other things than the words. So if you could, never shall lament cease, and try to make sure that nothing is distorted beyond what you would do when you were speaking, so that you don't drop your jaw 6 miles to the ground,
I've never seen a room of 100 people do that.
a highlighter cap. That'll work. Well, no, we need something you might not choke on.
Thank you.
first four, but in thus four. It says tenderly and slower. So can you go even slower? And can you make sure to stay on the vowels as long as possible so we don't get but so but so beautiful.